जय हिंद स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम कंचन हियर, योर इंग्लिश टीचर. एंड दिस टाइम आई हैव टेकन अ चैप्टर वेदरिंग द स्टॉर्म इन एरसामा. सो दिस चैप्टर इज फ्रॉम द बुक मोमेंट्स. एंड इन दिस चैप्टर यू विल रीड हाउ प्रशांत वॉज देयर इन स्टॉर्म. एंड दिस इज अबाउट नेचुरल डिजास्टर इन ओरिसा. एंड हाउ प्रशांत he had taken all the responsibilities as a good leader, and also he had done his job very well, and in this way he was successful to take out his family members and his villagers from that situation. So he was there as leader. So let's see that this story was written by Harsh Mander. So here, the cyclone that hit Orissa in October 1999 killed thousands of people and devastated hundreds of villages. So for two dreadful nights, Prashant, a young man, was marooned on the roof of a house. On the third day, he decided to go to his village. Did he find his family? So this is the situation that it was in 1999, that in Orissa a storm, that was big storm, and it was there in that place, and where two dreadful nights Prashant had spent, and he was not able to return back. So here on 27 October 1999, 7 years after his mother's death, Prashant had gone to the block headquarters of Irsama. Irsama is a small village town in coastal Orissa. So some 18 kilometers from his village. It was from his village about the distance of 18 kilometers. To spend the day with a friend, in the evening a dark and menacing means very dangerous storm quickly gathered. And winds beat against the houses with a speed and fury. That fury means angry, means here means speed, that Prashant had never witnessed. He had never seen such type of big storm in his life. Heavy and incessant means continuous rain filled the darkness. Ancient trees were uprooted and crashed to the earth. So big trees, they were uprooted means they were just uprooted means ukhad jana. Then they crashed to the earth means they were fallen down on the earth. And screams means cries rent the air. Cries were there, people were crying, as people and houses were swiftly washed. All the houses, they were thrown away, they were washed away, and then angry waters swirled into his friend's house. Miss angry water was there in his friend's house, neck deep. Now the building was of brick and mortar and was strong enough to survive the devastation. Means his friend's house was made of brick and mortar, so it was safe and it was not washed away. And then the wind's velocity of 350 kilometers per hour. But the cold terror of the family grew with the crashing of trees that had got uprooted and fallen on their house. So many trees, they were uprooted and they were fallen down on the house. And sometime in the middle of the night, damaging its roof and walls. So though the house was not washed away, it was there, but its roof was also damaged due to uprooted trees. The crazed destruction wrought by the cyclone and the surge of the ocean continued for the next 36 hours. So the destruction that was there due to that storm, it was there due to that storm, and it continued for the next 36 hours. Now, although wind speeds had reduced somewhat, wind was there reduced means it was not blowing, but by the next morning, to escape the waters rising in the house, Prashant and his friend's family, they had taken shelter on the roof of the house. So Prashant will never forget the shock he experienced at his first glimpse. He had seen for the first time in his life this type of scene of the devastation, means destroy and destruction wrought by the super cyclone in the gray light of the early morning. So a raging, deadly brown sheet of water covered everything, means everywhere there was water, and water, brown colored water, and it could seen easily. Only fractured cement houses still stood in a few places, and blotted animal carcasses and human corpses floated, means dead animals' bodies were floating, and dead human bodies were also there. Corpse means dead body were floating in every direction, all round. Even huge old trees had fallen. Two coconut trees had fallen on the roof of their house. This was a blessing because they had eaten the tender coconuts from the trees that were fallen down on the roof of the house, kept the family, trapped family, from starving. Starving means hungerness and dying due to hungerness in the several days that followed. So, okay, student, I will carry on in my next video. Thank you and Jai Hind.